This is a second video on digital electronics, showing the adder circuit. The adder circuit is an important building block for how computers work. This will explain about combinational logic, which is how logic gates can be combined to create a more complicated circuit. This shows the different logic gates, which are the fundamental building blocks of how digital computers work. I've already covered these in my earlier video on logic gates. If you're not familiar with logic gates, then there is a link in the description to that video. This example is on binary addition, but the principles also apply to other combinational logic circuits. Addition is a fundamental function of a computer's operation. This includes mathematical operations, including the obvious add two numbers together, but also integer multiplication, where a multiplier is a circuit which is based on the adder circuit, and in the internal operation for the processor, where the program counter may be a set amount and various other operations within the computer. First, we'll look at the half adder. The half adder is based on combinational logic, where different logic gates are grouped together to perform a more complex operation. In this case, there are two inputs, which are A and B, which go into an exclusive OR to give the sum, and in the event that both are 1, then there needs to be a carry output as well, which uses the AND gate. We can see this by filling in the truth table. Here, the adder has both inputs as 0. 0 plus 0 is 0, so both the sum and carry are both at 0. With a 1 on one of the inputs, then the exclusive OR condition is met, and so the output is 1. The same when the 1 is on A instead of B. It gives them 1 output from the exclusive OR, but does not meet the condition for the AND gate. Now, with both A and B as 1, the exclusive OR condition is not met, which gives a 0 for the sum. But the AND gate has 2 1 inputs, which gives a 1 output, so giving a carry out. That is a working adder. It's easy to understand. However, it's called a half adder for a reason. If you want to connect multiple adders together, which is needed for adding a binary number that's more than one digit, then you also need a third input, which is the carry in from the lower bit. To handle this, we need to use a full adder. As you can see, this circuit is more complicated, with 5 logic gates instead of the 2 used previously. It is still based on the same principles of using exclusive OR for the sum, along with AND gates for the carry out, although there are now 2 pairs of each of the gates, and there is an additional OR gate for the carry out. So this works by the first exclusive OR, which is used for the sum of A and B, and then the second exclusive OR works out the sum of the carry in. The AND gates look for a carry across A and B, and then across the output of the first exclusive OR and the carry in. These are ORed together, so if either AND gate indicates a carry, then the carry out will be 1. This is easier to see by filling in the truth table and working through the possible values. As you can expect, with all the inputs at 0, then both the sum and carry out are both 0. With a 1 on B, then both exclusive OR gates will give a 1 output, which is our sum. The carry out remains at 0. The same if it's A instead of B that is at 1. If A and B are both 1, with carry in still at 0, we have a carry out, which is through the bottom AND gate, and then the OR gate. So far, this has been the same as the half adder, as we've had no carry in. Now, the full adder is required, as we use the carry in input. With the carry in at 1, then it bypasses the first exclusive OR gate, but gives a high input to the second exclusive OR, which gives a 1 for the sum. With a 1 on the B input, then the first exclusive OR gives a 1 output, which combined with the carry in gives a 0 from the second exclusive OR. This does, however, give a 1 from the AND gate, which gives a 1 for the carry out. It's the same when we switch inputs A and B. Finally, when we have A, B and carry in all at 1, the first exclusive OR gives a 1 output, which means that the second exclusive OR has 1 input at 1, giving a 1 output. for the sum. The lower AND gate now goes high, giving a 1 from the carry out as well. That is the full adder complete, which adds 2 1-bit numbers and a carry in to give a sum and a carry out. This is the making of a full adder, which can add multiple bits together. Typically, you would have 8 full adders to handle 1 byte in an 8-bit processor. As you went up to 16-bit, 32-bit or 64-bit architectures, then those would increase as well. As the size of these multiply, then it no longer makes sense to show these as individual gates. So we can replace the 5 logic gates with a single symbol which represents a 1-bit full adder. So instead of showing the individual logic gates, we normally show the adder as a generic symbol block, which is a rectangular block with the title full adder. You'll also see these generic blocks used at a higher level of abstraction, so you may see an 8-bit adder represented by a single block with 8 inputs plus carry in, and then 8 outputs plus carry out. Here you can see a binary sum. Note, I'm going to assume that this is straightforward, unsigned 8-bit integer addition, which makes this easier to understand. In reality, computers often use 2's complement for binary addition, which would mean that the decimal equivalent would be different, but the way it works at the electronic level is still the same. So in decibel, this addition would be 50 plus 150 equals 200. Here you can see the circuit for an 8-bit adder. This is a ripple adder, which I'll explain. The default is usually for logic circuits to work from left to right, although in this case it's working from top to bottom. The least significant bit is on the right hand side, so that it's in line with the order of the bits of the sum. From the diagram, we have 8 full adders, with the carry out going to the adder to the left of it. The rightmost adder doesn't have a carry in, so that's set to 0. You could use a half adder for the rightmost adder, although for consistency, I've shown that as a full adder as well. I've now added the values across the top that are to be added together. But you'll see that the carries are set to a question mark. That's because the output of the carry isn't available until it's been able to propagate through the adder. So starting with the least significant bit at the right, you can see that we know all 3 inputs as carry in is at 0. So the output is 0 for the sum and 0 for the carry. So now the next adder has a 0 for the carry in. So we can calculate that as 0 for the sum and 1 for the carry out. You can see that the next sum would be a 1, except for now we have a carry in that is 1. So that actually gives that the sum of 0 and carry of 1. If we had tried to work that value out before we knew the state of the carry in, then the output from that would have been incorrect. Again, the value of the carry in is important in calculating the next value. And this continues through as we work through the rest of the addition. And this continues through. So the final output of all the 8 bits is not known until the carry has been allowed to propagate through all the adders. The delay at each stage is only very small, but it does introduce a delay, which gets longer as the adder gets bigger. This is known as a ripple adder, as the carry values have to ripple through the adder. There are other ways of creating fast adders which counteract this by using more logic gates. They introduce extra logic to look ahead of the previous stage, whether that will have a carry out or not. This significantly increases the number of logic gates, but speeds the counting up significantly. So this video has shown an example of a combinational logic circuit. You wouldn't normally build this yourself from individual logic gates, but you can buy an 8-bit adder integrated circuit, which includes all this. The adder is an important operation in how computers work, and so understanding this will give you a little insight into the workings of a computer. In a future video, I'll also be covering sequential logic, which includes flip-flops, registers, and shift registers. If these videos are popular, I'll look at adding more videos on digital electronics in future. So please subscribe to my channel to get notified of new videos. If there's something you'd like me to cover on future videos, either on digital electronics or any other maker topic, please let me know in the comments. If you found this useful, you may also like my book, Learn Electronics with Raspberry Pi, by Stuart Watkiss, published by Apress.